Chloe. I'm 9 and I'm going to be 10 in September. And today I'm going to talk to you about salty speech. I'm going to start with Proverbs chapter 15, verse 9. It says there, "A soft answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger." And I'm going to give an example for mostly the kids here, and I think that most of them have little brothers or sisters. So let's say that you're playing with one of your favorite toys, and then your little brother or sister comes and takes it away from you. You have two choices. You can yell and take it back from them, and they'll probably just yell back at you. Or you can use a soft answer and nicely ask them back for it. Tell them that they can play with it after you. And usually they'll give it back to you and respond nicely. Usually. Sometimes it doesn't work, but it's always better than using a harsh answer. And a soft answer is a salty answer. In Colossians chapter 4, verse 6, it says, "Let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each one." So the Bible tells us to season our speech with salt. A salty answer is a gentle and a calm but firm answer. We need salty speech to teach people about God. If someone is yelling at someone else saying that they need to believe in God and they're not, so they're bad, then that other person is not going to listen to them. We need to have salty speech or else people won't respond to us. I just want to share one more verse with you. Matthew 5, verse 13 says, "You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? It is then good for nothing but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot by men." So if we don't have salty speech, then we're not going to be effective. We need salty speech. Thank you.
Amen. So today the children are going to be coming up here and sharing something. On the third Sunday, normally we have the little ones come up, not just here, any little one. Families are doing a fantastic job. The first guy who's going to be up here is Zachary Fritz. This guy, we went to New Zealand together, and he shared to hundreds of people. When people were actually older than him in school, right there in Whanganui, New Zealand, the land of the long white cloud, and he got up and shared, not just once, but more than once. And so, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for my man, Zachary Fritz. We're raising tomorrow's generation today. Zachary, there you go, buddy. Yeah, right there. I'm going to put it on the chair. And Bailey, you're next after these, sweetheart, is that true? Where are you, Princess Bailey? Excellent. Will that work, Zachary? Awesome. Shocking, turn this mic a bit louder. Zachary, just do your thing, brother. Stretch your hands forward. Let's pray for Zachary. Lord, we thank you for your calling upon our children. That, Lord, true for the parents, it's true for our children and our grandchildren as well, and so on and so forth. While we were in our mother's womb, Lord, you called us. You knew us. Even before, you said to Jeremiah, before you were in your mother's womb, before the forming within the mother's womb, the fabric together, Lord, you call and you knew. Lord, we bless Zachary and those coming up here, Bailey, Shekinah, and Christian as well, and Micah, Lord, closing. We thank you for these treasures. Lord, your word says that children are an inheritance. They are a reward.
That's nice.
And we say we welcome them physically and spiritually as well. Spiritual reception to the next generation raised up today in the name of Jesus. Everybody said amen.
Amen.
Exactly. Bless the church.
Good morning. My name is Zachary. Today I'm going to share on the book of friendship. So first of all, please turn with me to John 15:11.
Together, a very good truth. So I'm
name out a few things that friends do to each other, and that you have to do to be good ones to be true friends. Friends help, friends give, friends are connected, friends save each other from danger, friends help each other know the world, friends teach each other, friends give to each other, and friends love. They have generous and their generosity and have kindness. Thank you.